Hey Star Wars fans, and our FLYGUY doing a fig review. Still on the Clone Wars this time, and this time it's Saesee Tiin. Hopefully I'm pronouncing that right. This is one of those beautiful looking Jedi. Again, ooh, never mind, his lovely green eyes there. But so he's a Jedi in the Clone Wars. We briefly get to see him, I think, in Season 3. I could be wrong, I can't actually remember. But Saesee Tiin, there he is. If not, I'm sure he's coming at some point. But here's some blurb on the screen about this guy. I don't even recall seeing him in the TV series yet, but never mind. Let us know in the comments below if you've seen this guy in the Clone Wars. I can't recall. A few other figures on there. We've certainly got some reviews and more are on the way, so you certainly will find Serapass in the reviews, and a few others will be coming along very soon. So there we go. He has this weird swiveling wing thing that goes in his back, and that's one of the things we'll talk about in just a minute. But some other stuff that comes in the pack, as is normal with these figures, a Galactic Battle Game card. We're going to continue to see these all the way through into the Phantom Menace line next year. Just a very different looking card itself. Also in the pack was one of these traditional stands we get with all of the Clone Wars figures. Another one of the die that goes to the Galactic Battle Game. You must have many of them, of the figures that we all have. And again, yet again, I don't have any more, so please don't send me an email. It's a Clone Wars Adventures code for the game that comes with it. Now, I'm just going to turn this around and show you the code. And if you're the first person to use it, then that's it. You're the first person to use it. So I don't have any more. So there you go. Code on screen. Freeze the frame. Put that into the Clone Wars Adventures, and you'll get some goodies on there. Please don't ask me for any more codes. I can't respond to you if you keep emailing me. So, sorry folks, that's it done. No more. The figure itself is pretty cool. He is pretty much a Jedi basic body with this pretty ugly looking face and this rather cool helmet which fits over. This is supposed to kind of go along with his spacesuit there. I have to say, I'm not really a fan of that helmet. I don't think it really does a great deal for the figure. Kind of makes him look like a floppy-eared dog there, but don't know, doesn't really work for me. But look, it's part of the kit itself, so we give it a review, and slightly Mandalorian clone trippery, obviously looking piece. But I don't know how much space protection he's getting there if it's barely covering his face. But there you go. So that is pretty much it, this figure. And if we look at the back, on the back of it there, there is some. Let's get it there. Some very cool artwork on his head. Some paintwork, I should say, on a transfer. Some kind of markings from him. And again, on his gauntlets, we have some markings as well on either side. Again, slightly Mandalorian looking. I've probably got the symbols wrong. Somebody can tell me what it is. But apart from that, he's pretty much a basic figure. Some nice paint on his face. Standard-ish Jedi body. But the other thing that comes with it, which I'm not really a fan of, as I said, is if we take his head off and you then put this attachment over his shoulders, you get this. Now, I can pretty much guarantee we're not going to get to see this jetpack wing thing in the Clone Wars TV series. So it looks like one that's been designed for younger peeps out there to have this extra Saesee Tiin thing which floats around. It extends out at the back and it doesn't look too bad, although the colour being bright green I'm not quite sure of. But look, you either love it or you hate it, and frankly I kind of hate it. It's just a worthless piece of plastic, and I'd have much rather Hasbro saved the money on this pretty, to me anyway, fairly junky looking jetpack thing and given the guy some ankles and some added articulation. But I guess that's the typical argument between collectors and younger kids, I guess, for play features. But there you go. Pretty standard lightsaber on this guy, although it's quite a unique hilt for him. Again, as is always these days, all one piece. Standard lightsaber that he has, but very nice. On the figure itself, underneath the skirt, you'll see there's knee articulation, no ankles articulation. Boo, Hasbro. Swivel hips, swivel waist, ball-jointed elbows, ball-jointed shoulders, and we do get some swivel wrists there, and a ball-jointed head. So articulation is pretty basic, but it works. Some nice kind of clips on the back there as his armour kind of moves. You'll see it goes around and it clips into the figure and just makes an extra kind of, I guess, slightly realistic looking piece for that armour to clip on. There we go. Some posing of the figure. And again, obviously, his cloth skirt. His Jedi skirt, or whatever you call those things. No holster on the belt for an extra lightsaber. And really, that's about it. Look, yet again, you probably love or hate this figure. It's a bit of a myth for me. I'm not too fussed on him. He's a cool Jedi. Doesn't look too bad. Not so sure about these big horns or the helmet, but as a standalone Jedi, he looks pretty much the part. Decent figure. I managed to get this from a store called Shop For Me. Nope, tell a lie, I didn't. Not Shop For Me. I got this from sagacentral.com.au through a friend who bought some figures for me, so thank you, Dan. And there you go. That's Saesee Tiin from the Clone Wars. So let us know what you think. You buying this figure or not really one for you? Comments below or on facebook.com/flyguy.net. And we'll have some more reviews coming up real soon. Cheers.